Hey data people, let's spend some time talking about how to use the take function in Excel. In simple terms, the take function quickly returns the desired rows or columns from a larger data set without manually sorting or filtering your data. This makes your analysis more efficient and streamlined to get the answers you need. To use a dynamic function like take, you'll need a newer version of Excel for Microsoft 365 or Excel Online. It's worth the upgrade for these power-packed time savers you'll use every day. And by including a few more functions into your mix, you'll soon learn how easy this tool performs more complex tasks with minimal effort. Here's the sales data we'll be working with. Let's start by showing you the take function in action with the proper syntax. Go ahead and start entering equals take parentheses and pause there for a moment. You can see that this function has three arguments to work with: array, rows, and columns. The array argument is the only required entry for this to work. Let's enter our range of data without any other parameters and see what happens. Be sure to include two commas for those empty arguments. As you can see, our entire range of data was returned to us. But let's add some more requests and show you how this function is a time saver. The second argument in take lets you choose us how many rows we want to return. If you enter a positive number, the rows returned begin at the top. For instance, if I enter a 3, I'll return the top 3 rows of data. If we want the last 3 rows, we'd enter a negative number to start returning from the bottom of the data. Now let's specify the columns. The same rules apply here. Entering a positive number, we'll have the take function pulling from the start or left of the data, and a negative number will pull from the right or end. And that's the take function. Pretty simple to use. But while pulling sequential lists of data is nice, we can make this more useful by adding some other formulas. For starters, let's sort our data to make it easier to work with. If you want an alphabetical listing, just add the sort function in front of the take. Or it might make more sense to sort our list by dollar value. To do that, we'll begin with the sort by function. Select the array and choose the range we want to sort by. In this case, we'll select the total revenue range and enter -1 for descending order. Since our list is sorted, we can now apply the take function and identify the top 5 sales reps. Just enter take in the front, a +5 for the rows argument, and close out with your empty column argument and parentheses. Now that we have our top 5 sales leaders, let's take it a step further and figure out what the average revenue is just for those sales. So you might be thinking you can throw the average function to the front of your existing formula, and while you'd get an actual value, it would be wrong. To make sure you're only calculating the average of the revenue alone, we have to add a value to the column argument in our take function. By entering -1, we're telling Excel to only show us the total revenue column. Then we can wrap our formula with the average function. That looks better. Another popular function you can use with take is the filter function. Let's say you want to analyze the data for all reps who sold over 30 items, and the manager wants to identify the rep from the threshold who's struggling the most. To find the correct sales rep, let's start by entering another sort by function. Select the data set for our array and choose the sort range of items sold in descending order. Now let's apply a filter function to narrow down our results. But this is where it can get tricky. Enter filter after the equal sign and your existing formula is your first argument, then type comma. Normally, you would think you could select your include argument of greater than 30 at this point. But if I do that now, you'll see I'm getting a return outside the arguments. Long story short, our previous sort function is now the first argument of the filter. Because of this, we need to resort the data to apply to the include argument. So go ahead and enter sort by like we did before. After the parentheses, we can enter the greater than 30 parameter, followed by the closing parentheses. Hit enter and you have your list. Lastly, apply the take function with a -1 for your rows argument and a comma for your empty columns argument. Let's go over one more example that you may come across, and that's using the take function with multiple data sets. Now we have 2 stores to compare. Along with the take function, we can use the VStack function to join the two together. You can combine these two lists simply by typing the VStack formula and selecting the ranges you need. You can see that we do have both lists together, but they're unsorted. But instead of sort by, let's use the sort function this time. Insert your sort, making the VStack your first argument. Next, we can choose an index to sort by. In our case, the third column is revenue, so we enter a positive 3. The next argument asks us to sort, and we'll choose negative 1 for descending. And you guessed it, we now add the take function. Let's wrap our existing formula to take the top 5 sales reps from the combined store list. But you know what? I don't think we want to see how many items were sold. Unfortunately, I can't add an argument into the take function to remove a column in between the two I want to keep, but I can add the CHOOSECOLUMNS function to modify the output. Go ahead and click into your formula, add CHOOSECOLUMNS to the front. Your existing formula is your first argument, and the remaining arguments are the index numbers for the columns to keep. Ours are columns 1 and 3. Hit enter and you're all set. I hope I've been able to help you understand how to use a take function in Excel. It has plenty of uses, and with the combined efforts of other helper formulas, you can transform data with purpose without other methods that require more direction. If you did enjoy the video, consider subscribing for other Excel tips and tricks to speed up your day. Thanks for watching.